In this video, we're going to talk about computer viruses. What are they? How do they work? And how can you protect your own computer and your business computers against viral attacks? G'day, Dan. How are you?
Good, thanks, Tim.
So let's talk about viruses. This is something that really gets your attention when you have one. How does it look when you actually have a virus active on your computer?
So you may not know that you have a virus for some days or even weeks, but you start seeing a few things go wrong, whether it's the keyboard not working, or whether it's the mouse moving from side to side in the wrong places. But over time, you see that your computer's just not performing the way that it used to be. Now, with something like ransomware, you might see a pop-up come up and say, you have ransomware, or you have been attacked.
Right.
Whereas with some of these viruses, you may just not even know until your computer completely slows down.
Okay. So what are these viruses after? If a ransomware is after money and a virus just sort of slows you down, why are they even on your machines? What are they sort of getting out of it?
So viruses are generally on there to be able to open the door for an attack to come in. Again, whether that is some kind of a data theft, or whether that's somebody just wanting to lock your computer down and give you the key based on a payment of bitcoins.
Okay.
So a virus is on there generally to open the door for some other malicious activity.
So if we're thinking viruses and ransomware and data theft, is that the kind of the big three you need to be worried about in terms of data security?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, good. So let's talk about antivirus protection. What should you be doing on your own PC? What should you be installing?
So when you buy a new machine, say it's a Windows 10 machine, it would normally have the standard Windows Defender on it, which is suitable for getting rid of some fairly basic viruses that would come on. Windows Defender is a good piece of software, but we would generally say couple that with one of the other industry leaders, such as Trend Micro or Symantec Antivirus, to be able to give you better antivirus protection. So you then load that on all the computers in the office. As well as that, if you have a server in the office or even a server in the cloud, you'd load the antivirus software on that as well.
Okay, so there should be antivirus software kind of everywhere, and beyond just the free Windows Defender that comes with Windows. I've seen some press recently about not trusting virus software from certain countries. I want to say, you know, you shouldn't have China-based or Russia-based. Is there any truth to any of those rumours?
I think from different commentators you would hear different stories about what is acceptable and what isn't. Generally, we try and stick to software which is made in the US or the UK or Australia. Occasionally, you'll have to use any virus software from a different country, most of the time Russia or some of the Asian countries. But yeah, we generally try and stick to something that's made in the US or the UK or Australia.
Once you have a virus on your machine, how do you go about removing that virus, or do you have to chuck the machine out and start again?
So you don't have to chuck the machine out. Normally the antivirus software that you have installed on there will be able to take care of the virus. If it doesn't, you can go to one of those websites I mentioned before, Trend Micro or Symantec. In a lot of cases, you can download a free antivirus tool without having to buy the software to be able to remove the virus.
As long as you know which one it is.
Yeah, that's right.
You've got to know which one it is first. Because in terms of that software, it's specific to the individual viruses. Am I wrong there, or is that?
No, sorry. So you can go to any of those websites and download their antivirus removal tool, which generally takes care of most viruses.
Really? And this can take care of everything. Oh, that's very nice of them.
So the thing that the antivirus companies don't provide you is that real-time security. That's what you have to pay for. So when you buy antivirus software, you're buying that real-time security that's always checking for viruses on your computer in the background when you're surfing the net and making documents and things like that. When you download it, it's not real-time security. You've generally got a virus you're trying to remove.
Okay, understood. What can we talk about in terms of computer virus protection and computer virus removal? What kind of ballpark price are we looking at here? You've said you get what you pay for. Are we talking 10 grand for the best thing there is? Or, you know, what sort of ballpark numbers are we talking about?
For good antivirus software, we generally look at somewhere between $5 and $10 per computer per month.
Okay, so it's renewed over time and it's refreshed and updated and what have you.
Yeah, so the monthly subscription gives you the latest antivirus updates. So if a new virus comes out in the next 10 minutes, you'll get that update come through. Mm. It also gives you product releases. So if new versions of the software come out by that antivirus manufacturer, The subscription also gives you the latest version of the software as well.
All right, Tripp, anything else we should cover when it comes to viruses in particular?
Don't disable it. Leave it on, leave it running, and make sure it's always up to date.
All right, excellent. Thanks very much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, or perhaps ask Dan or someone from his team more specific questions about what's going on for you and your business, please get in touch with us online through sabervox.com.au.